occasions define different periods of time within individual observations and can be useful to define inter-occasion variability or to use covariates that differ between occasions. I have already shown in the feature of the week video number 51 how to define occasions in a dataset to be used in the Monolix suite with the column types, occasion, and event ID. Let's now see in details how occasions are used in Monolix to model inter-occasion variability. In a standard mixed effects model, the observation model is composed of the prediction that depends on individual parameters phi I and a residual error that comes from the standard random variable epsilon. Each individual parameter is defined with its own model that predicts how much the value for each individual I deviates from the typical parameter value in the population phi pop. The inter-individual variability can be described by covariate effects, and the unexplained variability is represented by the random effect with a normal variable, eta. So two levels of variability are combined, the residual error and the inter-individual variability. The parameter can also be transformed to have a non-normal distribution. For example, here is the absorption rate Ka with a log normal distribution and no covariate. This model with no occasion assumes that each individual Ka belongs to the population distribution defined with the fixed effect Ka pop and the standard deviation of eta omega Ka and remains constant over time during the whole study, as displayed here, for example, for subjects 1, 2, and 3. Covariates would also need to be constant over time. However, this is not always the case, in particular if the observations have been recorded across different periods separated by long times. A simple approach to take into account the variation of individual parameters over time consists of splitting the study into several time periods or occasions and assuming that data from the same individual over occasions is correlated, which is modeled with individual parameters that can vary from occasion to occasion but remain constant within occasions. In this example, observations have been recorded during 6 successive periods of time for these 3 individuals, and we assume that the data will be better described with absorption rates that vary across occasions. This variation can be modeled by introducing an additional level of random effects representing the intra-individual variability for each individual parameter, based on a random effect eta ik, where I is the individual and k is the occasion, which is a new normal variable with a standard deviation called gamma ka in Monolix. This random effect defines a distribution based on the typical value across time for each individual parameter, described with the first random effect, and a standard deviation that is common to all individuals. So for subject 1, for example, an individual value Ka1 is drawn from the inter-individual distribution, and then for each occasion, including the first one, an additional inter-occasion variability is drawn such that the true Ka deviates a little bit from Ka1. The distribution of the parameters across all occasions of all subjects is then a combination of the random effect for inter-individual variability, or IIV, and the random effect for inter-occasion variability, or IOV. The total model with the error model has then 3 levels of variability, the residual error epsilon, eta for IIV, and eta for IOV. If between occasions variability is apparent, it is important to take it into account, otherwise it will be contained in the residual errors that won't be independent. This may produce bias in estimation of population pharmacokinetic parameters. It is important to note that occasions between individuals are independent. For example, eta 1,1, the random effect for the occasion 1 of individual 1, is not the same value as eta 2,1, the random effect for occasion 1 of individual 2. There are 2 different values drawn independently from the same distribution defined here. Thus, the inter-occasion variability represents also an inter-individual variability. The variability at the ID level represents the additional variability between individuals that is common across occasions. Sometimes it might be difficult to estimate the typical individual values across time, KAI, in addition to the IOV, and so it is possible to consider only IOV and no IIV, as we can see here. This is especially the case if there are few occasions per individual, or if the population is very homogeneous, or if most of the variability is explained by covariate effects. Note that it is possible to define washouts between occasions. You can watch the Feature of the Week video number 51 to see the different ways of encoding occasions and washouts in Monolix. Moreover, occasions do not actually have to be successive in time. It is also possible to encode in the dataset observations within the same individual that start at the same time or that have overlapping times, and this is also explained in the previous video. From a modeling point of view, washouts or overlapping times do not affect the way the variability is set up. Now that we know how IOV is modeled, let's have a look at an example in Monolix. This is a PK dataset that contains two occasions per individual. This is a crossover study where individuals have received food along with the drug on one of the two occasions and no food on the other occasion, with a random sequence. Occasions have overlapping times and all start at time zero. When I hover on some curve, on the plot of observed data, the other occasion from the same individual is highlighted as well in dashed lines. In the stratified panel, the covariates from the dataset are available: weight, the log transformation of weight, and food. If I color by food, I can see that the effect of food on the absorption is apparent. Moreover, the occasions are also available for stratification, for example, for splitting. The data has been described with a one-compartment model with a first-order absorption, a lag time, and a linear elimination. Because there are occasions in the dataset, two levels of random effects are available for the parameters in the interface, at the ID level for inter-individual variability and at the OC level for inter-occasion variability. The labels here correspond to the header names for the columns tagged as ID and occasion. The continuous covariate weight and its transformation appear at the ID level because it is constant for each individual, while the categorical covariate food appears at the OC level because it varies across occasions. In this project, I have kept only the random effects that could be estimated with a good confidence. And I have included some covariates effects and correlations between random effects that I could identify thanks to the statistical test: the log transformation of weight on V, food on TLAG and KA, and a correlation between the random effects of KA and CL at the OC level. Note that it is not possible to add an effect of food on V as indicated with a grayed out box. This is because V has a random effect for IIV, no random effect for IOV, and food varies across occasions. Covariates that vary with occasions can only be associated with parameters that either have IOV or that have no variability at all, like TLAG here. The formulas corresponding to this individual model can be seen with formula here. Notice that the random effects are named eta ID for the ID level and eta OC for the OC level. For example, CL combines the two random effects eta ID CL and eta OC CL. In results, I can see their estimated standard deviations. Omega CL is the standard deviation of eta ID CL and gamma CL is the standard deviation of eta OC CL. The correlation parameter is named core2KACL because the correlation is at the second level of variability for the parameters. In the statistical tests, the level of variability is also indicated next to each test considering random effects. In the plots with random effects, for example the distribution of the standardized random effect, it is also possible to separate the two levels of variability when the individual estimates displayed on the plot are sampled from the conditional distributions. In that case, the distribution displayed by default combines the variability from both levels. Here, there is variability for KA, V, and CL. I can then choose to display the distributions of eta IDV and eta IDCL, or the distributions of eta OC KA and eta OC CL. The same option exists for the plots of correlations between random effects. By default, both variability levels are combined. I can see a correlation of 0.254 between eta KA and eta CL. But when I focus on the OC level, I see a higher correlation of 0.551, which is due to the correlation between eta hoc Ka and eta hoc Cl included in the statistical model. Finally, on the individual fits, the predictions for each occasion are independent and are displayed by default on separate subplots. For example, here is the ID1 at occasion 1, and this is the ID1 at occasion 2. In display, I can disable the option Split Occasions to display all occasions from the same individual on the same plot, with different colors for independent occasions. Note that if the occasions are successive with no washout, they are not independent, so they appear with the same color. Finally, extension of the proposed approach to nested levels of variability is straightforward. Suppose that an occasion is split into several sub-occasions. For example, here the individual 1 has 2 occasions, each split into 3 sub-occasions. Note that the number of occasions does not have to be the same in other individuals. To take into account occasion by occasion variability and sub-occasion by sub-occasion variability, we can introduce an additional level of inter-occasion variability into the model such that each individual parameter combines 3 random effects. In Monolix, the standard deviation of the third random effect will be called gamma 2. This is it for IOV in Monolix. See you next week!